Let's talk about tokens. Tokens are the most basic or the fundamental building blocks of a program. So the smallest, most meaningful item or entity in a program is known as a token. Just in case this is looking a little zapping or confusing you to you, worry not. I'm going to show you a small C program and I'll help you identify all the tokens. So programs are composed of tokens. So let's try to identify all the different tokens in a given program. So on the right hand side of my screen, if you take a look, I have written a simple program which is kind of meaningless. Okay, don't look at what this program is trying to do. The purpose of this particular piece of code is to help you understand what is a token. So if you see the highlighter, each of the highlighted items in gray indicates one token. Int is one token, main is the second, round parenthesis is the third, this is the fourth, the fifth, const, float, pi, assignment, the constant 3.142, semicolon, int again, the variable name a, assignment 0, semicolon. So all these items which have been grayed, okay, these are known as individual tokens of a C program. So a program, if you see, is simply a composition of tokens. Now if you look at these tokens, you will identify, or you should be able to think by now, that there are about six kinds of tokens. The first one are words like int, const, float, int. These all have special meaning to a C compiler. These are known as reserved words or keywords in common discussion. Reserved words or keywords have specific meaning. So when I say int a, it indicates that a is going to be an integer type of data. That's why int has a special meaning or a special significance to a compiler. Now once we look at the keywords like int, const, let's look at the second type of components or second type of tokens. Like if you look at the word main, if you look at pi, if you look at a, if you look at printf, these are all examples of identifiers because these are names given by the user or the developer of the code. For example, for pi, I have given it capital pi. The variable, I have named it as a. The function to print this message, hello world, I have given it the name printf, or the C library has given it the name printf. So these are the second types of components or second type of tokens in a C program. So all these pi, a, printf, main, these are names called as identifiers because you're trying to identify something by giving a name. For example, a memory location is identified by the name a. Now, after that, the third type of token is something called as a string. So if you see hello world, it is enclosed between double quotes. So anything which is enclosed in double quotes is known as a string. Then the third type of a token, the fourth type of a token happens to be symbols like flower bracket, okay, the round parenthesis. These are special symbols because they have special meaning in a C program. Okay, this indicates the beginning and end of a block. All right, this indicates the call to the printf function. That means this indicates that after this parenthesis there is going to be something and the parenthesis is going to end and this entire thing is going to be sent to printf. So all these things, the flower bracket, this chap here, round bracket, are all examples of special characters. Now there's one more kind of a token. That token is operators. Assignment is an operator, plus is an operator. So operators are all mathematical operators like left shift, right shift, okay, unary operators. These are all examples of operators. Here there is assignment plus, this is an example of a operator. And the last kind of the token happens to be a constant. So if you look at here, 3.142010, these are all examples of constants. So if you just glance at a program is going to consist of keywords like int, const, float. What are keywords? Words that have specific or special meaning to a C compiler. For example, when I say constant float pi, that means it says pi is a real number of the type floating or real type, and it's a constant. That means you cannot change the value of pi in your program. Operators are like equal to, comma is not used, but comma is also operator plus. This is an example of a operator. Identifiers are like a, pi, printf, main, etc. Constants are 3.142, 0, 10, etc. Strings are anything enclosed in double quotes. Examples of special characters are flower braces, round parentheses, and so on. Now, I need to talk a little bit about keywords. So if you look in a C program is primarily composed of, or has, a C language has basically 32 keywords. As our journey in C programming continues, you'll be able to get a feel of all these keywords we will be encountering, and you will get a detailed idea of what the keywords really mean. So far, we have used keywords like int, long, we have used short, we have used unsigned, okay. So we have used a number of them. For example, I've shown you enum, I've shown you else, I've shown you if. Okay, these are all examples of keywords. You cannot declare a variable called as int f, if, sorry, because int is a reserved word, which is fine. But if is also a word which has a special meaning to a compiler. So when you give if, it gets confused with the if statement. So please do not use any of these as names of variables or names of functions. So this should have given you an idea of what exactly are tokens in a C program. So frequently you ask, what is a token? You can say tokens are building blocks of a C program. They are the smallest and the most meaningful components joining which creates a C program, or they are the building blocks of a C program. So using all these individual components or tokens, we are able to create a C program. So a C program is simply a collection of tokens. So what your compiler does is, it will first break down your program into tokens, and then it will try to see if the arrangement of tokens is meaningful. For example, if I put a plus a is assigned 10 here, then that is not a meaningful arrangement of tokens, because on the left side of the assignment, you need to have a single variable. So I hope with this, I'm able to clarify your understanding of what is a token, and what, most importantly, what are keywords or reserved words in C. Just to be sure, there are just 32 reserved words in C, and you're not supposed to use any of these as names of variables or functions.